The primitive herbal use of mind-altering hallucinogenic plants practiced by the Night Sisters of the Dark Side of tidally locked Dathomir was largely medicinal. This corrupt coven of dark side magic practicing witches used not only the strange olfactory powers of perfumes created by wafting the smoke from a burning basin, and not only to induce mental hallucinatory states even capable of inducing apparent invisibility due to force blindness. They could also use their combined energy powers to influence the midichlorians in a living being's cells to metastasize any latent or dormant genetic traits they chose. They used this method in constructing the Sith assassin Savage Opress.
Who was his father?
There was no father. I carried him, I gave birth, I raised him. I can't explain what happened.
According to the Sith legend of Darth Plagueis, the wise Dark Lord of the Sith, told by Grand Chancellor Palpatine to Jedi Guardian Knight Anakin Skywalker, it could have actually been this earlier Sith Lord, the legendary Dark Lord who mastered Darth Sidious, Palpatine himself, that impregnated Shmi Skywalker by use of long-distance dark side force manipulation of her ovarian midichlorians to create life. Because Darth Plagueis was the Sith Dark Lord and Master over Palpatine, and according to Palpatine's recitation of the Sith legend, Darth Plagueis was killed by his apprentice in his sleep, it may prove to be difficult to determine the validity of this claim, due to the apparently conflicting years of his death, sometime between 52 and 46 BBY, and the supposed year of Anakin Skywalker's birth, in 41 BBY. Although it would be his apprentice, Darth Sidious, who would go into galactic politics to influence the Republic Senate as the representative from the sovereign system of Naboo, it was Darth Plagueis who instructed Darth Sidious in all the manner of uses of the Force that Darth Sidious would eventually employ himself. Considering that Darth Sidious proved more cunning and devious than his unsuspecting master, comes as no surprise to a student of the schools of philosophy on the nature of the Force at that time. The Living Force school focused on study of the midichlorians in order to channel the will of the Force. The Unifying Force school believed in studying cyclical patterns of events throughout history. Because most of what we know about the Darth Honorific and Darth Sidious in particular comes from the secret Wavelund manuscript describing these, and because almost all of what we currently know about Darth Plagueis, Sidious' master, comes to us secondhand or from Sidious himself, it is almost impossible at this present time to establish an accurate portrayal of Darth Plagueis. Of the mathematically gifted Muon species from Munalist, renowned already at that time for their intergalactic banking clan, Darth Plagueis would have been born speaking both Muon and galactic basic languages. As a young Muon spacer, Darth Plagueis was attracted toward learnings about midichlorian manipulation to induce spontaneous generation of a fetus inside an unsuspecting woman's womb. Such plans for the creation of a Sith homunculus involved the use of Sith alchemy and dark side magic to imbue the conception of a living being by a stranger at a distance. The process may have been based on similar principles to those later experimented with by Darth Sidious and his apprentice Darth Vader, involving bridging the midichlorian replication sequence dilemma in creating a force-sensitive clone. The virgin birth myth about the prophecy of the Chosen One implied that though the Jedi forbade experiments like those pursued by the Sith Darth Plagueis to create a Force-sensitive homunculus from a distance, they were open to the idea that even events against astronomical odds, such as the virgin birth of the Chosen One in the form of Anakin Skywalker, could yet occur naturally through the will of the Force alone. However, if Anakin Skywalker was such a Sith homunculus, whether generated by Darth Plagueis or by Darth Sidious himself, would explain very much about why the course taken by the path of his fate led him to betray the Jedi and turn to the Sith. It is known that Darth Sidious's work on immortality through cloning continued on long after his first death in the destruction of the second Death Star above the forest moon of Endor in 4 ABY. Although it would ultimately be erased from the memories of all those involved, during the Clone Wars, Jedi Master Obi-Wan Kenobi, Jedi Knight Anakin Skywalker, and Jedi Padawan Ahsoka Tano were transported to a planet hidden to all external detection called Mortis. There they met a family of three so-called Anchorites, who belonged to a more evolved life form called Force Fielders, combining both biological traits and Force spirit qualities into one form of body.
The planet is the Force.
The Anchorites tested Anakin Skywalker to ascertain if he was truly the Chosen One, sent to bring balance to the Force. After realizing how to draw extraordinary amounts of telekinetic Force power from the living Force of the planet Mortis itself, Anakin faced the test placed before him by the Anchorite father. He summoned monumental amounts of Force strength to telekinetically manipulate the Anchorite Force fielders and defeated them in a test of his abilities while freeing his master and apprentice. In so doing, although he would never again know he had, Anakin Skywalker proved himself the Chosen One, capable of bringing balance to the Force. Anakin Skywalker defeated both the light and dark Anchorite children by making them bow before him using only his telekinetic strength and the Force. By doing so, he changed the archetypal course of galactic history, passed the test of the Anchorite Father, and proved himself the Chosen One, bringer of balance to the Force.
Can you help her?
Once more, before having their memories of these events erased from their minds by the Anchorite father upon their leaving, while still on the planet Mortis, Anakin Skywalker, the Chosen One, once more proved his worth in a test of his force of willpower in convincing the Anchorite father to allow his dying daughter to let her own fading life force infuse the corpse of Anakin's apprentice Ahsoka. The Anchorite father consented and proceeded to watch over a guided ritual wherein Anakin Skywalker himself served as the Force energy gateway for this circuit to connect Ahsoka's corpse to the dying Anchorite daughter. The process worked and, although he would never remember it later, so far as it is known now, Anakin Skywalker once again proved himself as the Chosen One and saved the people he cared about from dying, accomplishing his own lifelong goal to cheat death.
Hey, Snips.
The fourth great schism of the Jedi Order, in 2000 BBY. This time resulted in 50 fallen Jedi Knights joining Phanius when he fell to the dark side to become Darth Ruin and go on to reestablish the new Sith Empire. This new Sith Empire had already been divided due to internal schisms of its own in the form of the Second Sith Civil War by the time of the beginning of the Rusan campaigns in 1002 BBY. By the time of the new Sith Wars between the Sith Brotherhood of Darkness, led by the Sith Chosen One Darth Bane, self-proclaimed first Dark Lord of the Sith, the combatants on both sides were beginning to weary of their combats, which had, by then, lasted more or less continuously for the last 1,000 years. By the time of the Seventh Battle of Rusan, the Sith had grown far more impatient and desperate for a way to avoid their continued stalemate than the Jedi had anticipated. Facing down the Brotherhood of Darkness, then holed up on the mid-rim planet Rusan and the Tarab sector, were the Army of Light, assembled under Jedi Master Lord Hoth, commander of the Republic military. Following a 2-year series of 6 battles fought in space along hyperspace trade routes near Rusan, and finally culminating in the bloodiest battle in galactic history on and below the surface of the planet itself, Jedi Lord Hoth eventually cornered Dark Lord of the Sith Empire and founder of the Brotherhood of Darkness, the Sith named Lord Khan, in the caverns below the surface of Rusan. But it was too late. Dark Lord Khan had long ago gone insane from his quest for power and detonated a mechanism called the Thought Bomb. The Jedi had been deceived that day and allowed their real enemy to escape and live on to reform the Brotherhood of Darkness according to a new rule of two. Darth Bane, with his apprentice Zana, would take the failed new Sith Empire underground as long-term infiltrators by adhering to the rule of two. Only ever a single master and a single apprentice comprised the entirety of Sith at this time. The Jedi, for their part, tried to rebuild Rusan's Valley of the Jedi and honor their dead as much as possible, despite the savagery of the method of their killing, which caused their souls to become imprisoned in a Force Nexus in what later came to be called the Cave of the Jedi below Rusan's surface. Darth Bane had been absent during the detonation of the Thought Bomb on Rusan because he had fled to Li Han, originally called Rakata Prime, to transcribe much of the original contents, which included the methods of making the Thought Bomb, from the original Sith holocron of Darth Revan to the Telos holocron. The contents of Sith holocrons often overlapped one another to some extent. However, it is known the data of the Telos, containing some of the Revan holocron, as well as peripheral notes about the Sith Code by Sith Lord Cordis, a contemporary of both Darth Bane and Darth Khan, was in the possession of Darth Plagueis, the Dark Lord Master of the Sith some 950 light-years following the establishment of the Rule of Two by Darth Bane. Darth Plagueis himself may or may not have known of and studied the technology of the Thought Bomb from the Telos copies borrowed from Darth Revan's original holocron recordings on its designs, and we cannot discount the Darth Sidious, whom the galaxy knows better by the now odious name Palpatine, himself may have had access to study the information on the Telos copies regarding the creation and use of Thought Bomb technology.
Rejoice for those around you who transform into the Force. Mourn them do not, miss them do not.